part of commemorations to mark the 32nd National Heroes Day today, we bring you profiles of the men and women who have stretched the limits of athleticism and inspired the nation to great heights.
Paul Sally is a football hero who stood between Uganda goalposts at the last time Uganda Cranes reached the Africa Cup of Nations finals in 1978 in Ghana, Accra. Uganda lost 2-0 in the finals to the host country Ghana, and he notes that they had a cluster of hard-working players. He asked government to remember the pledge they promised the players who achieved in the 1978 finals.
Me, I want to appeal to the government to stick to their promises. Last time, the promise of all those who represented the country and they go to honors for the country, they will be in one day. But those are political statements. No, none of us has ever put anything. Somebody cannot tell me that a country like Uganda can fail to compensate players who did something for the country. We reached the finals of Africa Cup. But up to now, nothing has happened. Most of our friends have died. But we have never been compensated. People who won the honors, they are not honored.
Patrick Lihanda, the current national boxing coach of national boxing team The Bombers, represented Uganda back to back in 1984 and 1988 Olympic Games in Los Angeles in South Korea, respectively. Lihanda is amongst the many decorated boxers in Africa and the international scene at large.
Only challenge we have now is that those days we were in schools. That's why we need to take boxing back to schools, because we used to do very good when we were in schools. But at the moment, we don't have institutions on board. Let's say like UPDF, KCCA prisons. If all those companies come on board, then I think we shall improve on our boxing. This one is just a request from the government, because also coaches, they do a lot, they contribute a lot to boxing in Uganda. So if a boxer like myself, we represented Uganda in different games, we raised the flag of Uganda high, so tomorrow is Heroes Day. If they can consider and also give us medals for the same, it will be very good, and I know it's possible.
Not to forget Sheila Agonzibwa, who is one of the long-serving female sports federation heads in Uganda, having joined the Uganda Handball Federation leadership in 1992 till date. Agonzibwa has achieved strides in baseball as well by helping them to construct a world-class baseball court in Gayaza on top of using her own funds.
What we really want, or what we are crying for, is to be facilitated. Let's also share on the national cake. If we have to get some money allocated to us, let's know in advance. Say like this year you get so much, so that we plan accordingly and see how far we can reach. Because if you give others the lion's share and then the rest suffer, it's not fair at all. It means you are killing other games and then you are raising just one sport. So what we want to our bosses is that if they can give us something substantial to make sure that we run these games. And me really, I as an individual, I would want money to do a lot of training within the country, to train both the athletes and the coaches and the referees, so that by the time we get opened up, the game is everywhere and you have a lot of talent to pick from.
Salim Mosoke is another long-serving federation president here in the sport of weightlifting. And he has been part of weightlifting administration since 1976. Throughout the years, Mosoke has attracted different partners to support him, including the government, which has helped him to guide different Uganda weightlifters to qualify for Commonwealth and Olympic Games.
You cannot run sports. You should understand this. Don't think that the government, National Council of Sports, the Uganda Olympic Committee, and so can do that without you. You should put patriotism into something so that they can see and help you. I'm very sure that National Council of Sports can see what I'm trying to do. I've been with the Uganda Olympic Committee for a number of years. I was a treasurer for 10 years. And I left Uganda Olympic Committee with very clean hands. And I'll be leaving weightlifting or sport with clean hands. But if I'm still alive, even if I've got another body to run, I'll be helping.
Sports worldwide has become a marketing anointing tool for countries. However, most athletes and administrators who render almost their entire life serving in sport end in a rock-bottom life of wanting. It is a void we can eliminate. Report compiled by Peter Kanyike for the news.